the name of Jesus. Christ has redeemed us from the curse of the law. He has been made a curse for us. For cursed is everyone that is hanged on the tree. Jesus has settled it all. He bought it and settled it with his blood. He did not shed his blood in vain. He said it. It is finished. I have done it all. I have settled it on your behalf. Oh yes, I step out on your behalf. I have fought the battle for you. I have given you the victory. You don't need to wrestle with sickness and disease anymore. I bore the pain for you. I bore it all for you. I took it all for you. Even though I was rich, I became poor for your sake, that you will be rich. I have promised you, I will supply all of your needs. Everything that represents a need, he says, I will supply it according to my riches in glory, not according to the world's economy, not according to what is happening around us, but according to my riches in glory. Everything you have need of, I settle it. I am a good God. Oh yes, I delight in the prosperity of my children. Seeing them prosper gives me delight. Oh yes, ekedeba sokobo shekede bazahata. Thank you, Father. This is a year of visions. Thank you for revelation knowledge. Thank you for visions. Thank you for ideas. Thank you for giftings, Lord, that will bring us before kings and not men. Begin to thank God for it. Begin to thank God for it. The gift that is on the inside of you, begin to find expression. It will not be hidden in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, our voice will be heard in this land in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, we are relevant in this land in the name of Jesus. We are influential in this land in the name of Jesus. Because the word of God tells us that we are the salt of the earth. Oh yes, wherever salt is added, it adds flavor. It changes the atmosphere. Yes, we build a wall of fire round about us. We're untouchable to every host of darkness in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, we plead the blood of Jesus over each and every one of us in this house, over our household, over our children, our spouses. Oh yes, our family members far and near, we plead the blood of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for we bear upon our bodies the mark of our Lord Jesus. We're exempted from every evil all around in the name of Jesus. It doesn't matter what the enemy has planned. It doesn't matter. He will not come near us, for 1,000 shall fall by our side, 10,000 by our right side. He shall not come near us. Only with our eyes we will behold and see the reward of the wicked. In the mighty name of Jesus, thank you, Father, for your angels that keep charge over us day and night. Day and night, they watch over us. All things have passed away. It's a new beginning for us. It's a new season for us. It is newness in every area in the name of Jesus. We refuse to allow old patterns, old habits, old ways of doing things, of thinking, to stop us. We're going forward. We're going higher. In the name of Jesus, we press forward. We We press forward. We take a rightful position for who we are in Christ Jesus. Father, Lord, we thank you, Lord. We bless your holy name. We thank you for this day. We thank you for this time. Thank you especially for the month of August. Thank you for the newness, the freshness, new beginnings. Thank you for the band of wickedness is destroyed. The works of the devil is destroyed. In the name of Jesus, thank you for great turnaround in every area of our lives. It will be obvious to all. Things will not remain the same again. In the mighty name of Jesus. We refuse to stay the same. We refuse to stay the same. In the mighty name of Jesus. I want us to begin to thank God for the word that will come forth this day. It's a word direct from the throne room of our Father. Thank you, Father. We receive fresh revelation. We receive insights from your word in the name of Jesus. Your word comes forth. It will not fall to the ground void. It will prosper in our lives. The word you have for us, Father, Lord, shatter strongholds, destroy every works, every plan of enemy in the name of Jesus. Oh yes, our mind is renewed through your word in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we bless you, Lord. We glorify you, Lord. I surrender to you, Lord, laying it all at your feet. Yes, Lord, you speak through me in the mighty name of Jesus. It's all about you, Lord. Let your name be glorified. Holy Spirit, I depend on you. Thank you, Spirit of a living God. Thank you for revealing the mind of the Father to us this evening. Thank you, Spirit of truth, for you will teach us all things this evening. Thank you, blessed Lord. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. Well, welcome to the 8th. Please be seated in God's presence. We thank God for his grace, abundant grace. God has great plans for us. And as we have declared, we know when we pray according to his will, he hears us, he answers us, and we rest assured we have answers to our prayers. In the name of Jesus, things will not remain the same. Says if we believe, all things are possible. As long as we believe, the word of God tells us when we pray, we believe that we have received answers to our prayers. In the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. It's absolutely important. And we thank God for this time of prayer. You know, I was just talking to someone today and I was like, do you sense that all around, everybody is so sensitized towards prayer. Even some churches, you know, that normally would not, you know, everybody's just like, there's something, there's so much expectation. And we know that Elder Bolari stressed on that, emphasized on that on Saturday. And the Bible tells us the expectation of the righteous shall not be cut off. We must come expectant. I don't know what we feel, sense, expect this season. But one thing is, things will not remain the same. In the name of Jesus, it is getting better. It has turned around because the Lord has already done it. He has already settled it. And, you know, just while we're praying and thinking, and I was pondering on this, and, you know, it just came to mind that, you know, somebody will be thinking, all of these prayers, I've prayed. Is it really making a difference? Have you thought about what if you didn't pray? Can you ever imagine what will happen if you don't pray? Don't joke with the time of prayer. There's no time we spend in God's presence that is wasted. There's no time we lift up our voice to the Almighty God that is wasted. God doesn't joke with it. So we shouldn't either. We shouldn't joke with our prayers. Even if it's just something that you just stay here and somebody prays and you just say, but you say amen. That amen is heavy in the hands of God. It means a lot. Amen. I want us to look at Habakkuk 2:1-3. Just look at a few scriptures and just go into a little bit of exhortation as we go into another time of prayer. This is still not coming up. Habakkuk 3, 2, 1 to 3. I'll just read from the message. It says, what's God going to say to my questions? I'm braced for the worst. I'll climb to the lookout tower and scan the horizon. I'll wait to see what God says. I will answer my complaint. 2 and 3, and says, and God answered, write this, write what you see. Write it out in big letters so that it can be read on the run. This vision message is a witness pointing to what's coming. It aches for the coming. It can hardly wait. And it doesn't lie. If it seems slow in coming, wait. It's on its way. It will come right on time. Amen. That's what God answered, responded to Habakkuk. So it seems like nothing is happening to us or in our mind. But God says, I'm doing a lot behind the scenes. So just write it down. Hold on to it. Focus on it. Habakkuk 3, 17 to 19. It says, though the cherry trees don't blossom and the strawberries don't ripen, though the apples are worm-eaten and the wheat fields stunted, though the sheep pens are sheepless and the cattle barns empty, I'm singing joyful praise to God. I'm turning cartwheels of joy to my Savior God, counting on God's rule to prevail. I take heart and gain strength. I run like a deer. I feel like I'm a king of the mountain. Amen. What the Lord is saying to us now is like, this is for, like I mentioned earlier, you know, some people just feel, I've been praying for years. This has been longstanding. There's been issues. I've done everything. I've tried everything. But God says there's nothing you've done that is wasted. Sit back again. Write it out again clearly. Write it out again clearly. Focus on it and trust me in this. Our God is a God that never fails. And he purposely came and gave us that word this year through his son. Might be Pastor Bayo that gave the word, but it's direct from the throne room of the Father. And he says, this is a year of possibilities. And he backed it up with his word. Luke 1:37, for with God nothing shall be impossible. Mark 9:23 says, if only you believe, all things are possible. Ephesians 3:20, and God who is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you can ever think, ask or imagine. That means our mind cannot even fathom what God has in store for us. And that's why he told Habakkuk there, he says, be excited. It doesn't look like it. It looks very bleak. It looks dead. It looks like nothing is happening. And for some of us, we look around and we compare. My friend, my peers, those behind me, younger than me, those that came yesterday, they've gone far. But you know, everybody's stage level is so different. Just saying this now, I remembered when we first landed in Canada. I came pregnant with Tony. That tells you how many years we've been here now. And we were going for those prenatal classes. And I was like, maybe about 3-4 months. But we're going every time. And then there were some people that came. But you know what? They were like 7, 8, 9 months, almost ready to give birth. And they were all giving birth. But if I had worried at that time at 3 months that they are coming and they're having their babies, I want mine now. Do you know what that means? So that's the way it is. But Habakkuk 3 tells us, while God is working, because he is working and he's working behind the scenes, rejoice, be happy, be glad. It's a process. Make the vision plain. You will go through the process, but what matters is the end result. So keep that end result in front of you. And all you see, that is all you see. The vision, the dream, what he has told you. And as you see that, you just rejoice. You just rejoice. You just rejoice. He has told you how it will happen has nothing to do with us. Because we cannot even think of how we will do it. No matter how much we try to sit down and plan it out in our minds, God is God. After we've done our planning, he will now come from the other side. And if we're too focused on our own way, our own thinking, our own expectation of how he should do it, we might miss out on what he's saying. Because sometimes the way he brings it doesn't look like it. And that's why Habakkuk is telling us, rejoice. He says, can we focus on it? Habakkuk 3:17-19, I think 18 or 19, where he says, I will just focus. No, 19, go to 19. No, he says, the Lord is my strength. No, okay, 17. Maybe it's the Message version that I read, where it says, I will focus on God that is able to prevail to rule. Okay, counting on God's rule to prevail. So I'm counting on God's power. I'm counting on his ability. We've been, possibility has been broken down to us. Thank you, Elder Bolarin, because it won't go away. So we know it's the power, the ability. God has that power. He has the ability. He has everything he needs to bring it to pass. He doesn't need any of our help. He doesn't need any one of us in any way. He has everything and every way to bring it to pass. All he's saying is, enjoy the process. Enjoy that time. Because I'm doing something. Let's look at 1 John 5:4. As we wait, as we see through, because we're looking at a lot of things. And just remember that analogy of a baby. If you are 2-3 months pregnant and you see a 7-month or 8-month or 9-month old pregnant woman giving birth and you're worried and you're fighting, you know that baby, you know what is going to happen. So just enjoy your own process because your time will come and it will come big, it will come beautiful. He says, every God-begotten person conquers the world's ways. The conquering power that brings the world to his knees is our faith. Your faith. That's one thing that the devil cannot fight. When he comes this way and you're able to stand, we see it with Jesus. He came in every way. He said Jesus just fasted and he was still in the spirit and the devil came. The audacity. But Jesus stood, and after a while, he said he left. But if you go and read the scripture, it says he left for a season. So he's looking for that time again when his faith will seem to go down. The devil never goes. So we must stand in faith. We must stand believing. The process is always seems like the toughest time, the time of waiting. But it's a process because God wants us. There's something he wants to do in us. And honestly, if we don't go through the process, we're only extending and elongating what God wants to do. Because he won't give us some things until we're ready for it. And it's personal. You might look at the person beside you and say, how did that person get? Everybody is ready at different levels. So if we don't prepare ourselves and realize and just focus on the end result, I don't care how it looks. I know. Without a shadow of doubt, my God is faithful, and I stand in faith. Like he said, Abraham believed. He did not look at the deadness of his own body or the deadness of Sarah's womb. And Sarah herself, that scripture always, I'm not sure, I don't want to go into it, but I just always remember it. It says, Sarah herself received power to conceive until Sarah received faith. to conceive. Abraham believed because he's walked with God. But Sarah herself had to receive power to conceive before she conceived. So if we don't grow ourselves into it, then where God has already done, mapped out what he wants to do. And we'll look at two people in the Bible. We'll look at David. I'm not going to go into it, but it's in 1 Samuel 13. We can read it later, and 16. Just read the story of David. But David won, and this could be the picture of somebody. You know, you look at yourself. I mean, nobody reckons with me. David could have said that because his brothers, if you read the story, nobody thought anything good about him. And in my own mind, I looked at it. His brothers probably were sent to university. They had their master's, PhD, the best of schools, and they were with Saul. They had the best of everything. But David was sent to the backside of the desert. Nobody thought any good thing good could come out of him. But God chose him. He says in 1 Samuel 13, 14, it says, the Lord sought out for himself David. The Lord sought him out for himself. So when you think you're in the backside of the desert, and then after David was anointed, even when Samuel came, even Samuel never thought, he looked at every other person, he thought they would fit in. And God said, no, the one I've chosen is the one. And even after he was anointed, what happened? He went back to the backside of the desert. You know, it's always sweet when we read other people's story. It's always nice when we read. But David had to go there. And he was being prepared. He was being prepared. And there's no time we heard about David's attitude, not just being, my father doesn't love me. He was being prepared, and he knew God was preparing him, and he was ready, and he was preparing himself. And when there was war, there was battle, and he came. He was ready to face battle. The ones that were educated and trained and had all the gadgets, they could do nothing with Goliath. But because David was prepared. And we could read the story. It took him years before he actually became king. But God prepared him. And when he became king, we've read about David's exploit. And Joseph, too, is the same thing. He had a dream. It didn't make sense. But all the process, he had to go all through the process because he cannot just come from slavery and become prime minister. You can't rule people like that. So he had to rule in the house of Potiphar first. And then he went into the prison and he ruled there. But the only thing that kept him going is his faith. All he saw, same thing with David, is that end result. The vision, it was clear, it was plain. I know I'm a king. I know I will sit on the throne. Same thing with Joseph. I know that these people will bow down to me. It doesn't matter what anybody does to me or says to me. They will bow down to me. And by faith, in faith, he stood and he believed. And it came to pass at the right time, at the set time. Just like Habakkuk said, it may seem like it's tiring, but it will come to pass. At the time that is appointed, it will come to pass. I want us to rise up now. We'll go into a time of prayer, just thanking God. First of all, for some of us, just laying down at the feet of God. Some of us might need to repent and ask for forgiveness because we've said some things that actually is working against us, not working for us because of all of this. It will not work. It's not for me. It can't work. So many things we've said. And sometimes these words work against us. It's not what anybody is doing. It's not the devil. We've spoken against ourselves. Begin to cancel, begin to nullify any negative word that you have spoken, anybody has spoken concerning you. We bring it under the blood of Jesus. We refuse it, we disallow it. Every evil handwriting of ordinances against us in the name of Jesus, we declare it will not see the light of day. In the mighty name of Jesus, we begin to rewrite our story. We begin to rewrite, we begin to dream again. We see the vision, we see the end results. Oh yes, for your word has promised me and assured me that it doesn't matter how good, how bad it looks. Yes, the thoughts you have towards me, they are of good and not of evil. To give me a future, a hope and an expected end. I know it's going to be a glorious end. I know it's going to be beautiful. I thank you, Father, Lord, for what you're doing in my life. I thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. I thank you for your mercy, for your grace. I thank you, Lord, for your loving kindness. Thank you, mighty God. You are God. I receive all that I've heard today. Lord, it doesn't matter with this. Lord, I thank you, Lord, for the process. I receive grace. I receive strength in the name of Jesus. I receive discernment. Yes, Lord, to be able to wait at your feet, sit at your feet in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, for the new beginning. I thank you for the new beginning. I press forward into this new. I know that the beginning you have for me is so glorious, is beautiful. I'm excited about it. I press forward into this new. I press forward into this new. Father, you brought the children out of Israel, out of Egypt, to bring them into their promised land. I thank you because you are bringing me into that promised land. I thank you for you are bringing me into that land filled with milk and honey, the land you have already prepared for me. Oh yes, I thank you, Lord. There will be no delay. I will not delay myself, and I refuse. I disallow anything and anyone delay me. Oh yes, everything around me that does not look like it. I thank you because I'm not moved by what I see. I'm not moved by what I hear. I stand upon your word. I thank you for your word is true. Your word is true. Your word is settled forever, Lord. Your word is settled. You have the final say. No man has the final say. You have the final say. I choose to believe. I choose to hold on to what you have to say concerning me. I receive your word, your promises concerning me. I thank you for this year of possibility. Oh yes, Lord, like Mary said, be it unto me according to your word. I don't see how. It doesn't look possible. It doesn't look feasible. But it doesn't matter how it looks. You have said it. I believe it. Be it unto me according to your word. I thank you for turning impossible situations around. Thank you for settling me. In the name of Jesus. I'm so glad. I rejoice in what you have for me. I rejoice in what you have planned for me. I thank you, mighty God. Yes, my season of possibilities. Oh yes, Lord, you are God who move mountains. You cause walls to fall. Every wall of hindrance, every wall standing in the way, you cause walls to fall. It took you nothing for the wall of Jericho to fall. There's nothing you cannot do. There's nothing you cannot change. There's no situation you cannot turn around. Thank you, Father. It doesn't take you too long. You are God who does the impossible. That is your specialty. We thank you, mighty God, that you have assured us this year, the God of possibilities, you are with us, changing things, turning things around, stepping into situation. Oh yes, causing systems to be under pressure for our sake. Oh yes, causing the natural, oh yes, the super to come upon the natural. In the name of Jesus, changing laws for our sakes. In the name of Jesus, promoting us when we seem unlikely, the least likely to be promoted. Yes, you bring us from the back to the front. In the name of Jesus. Yes, Lord. Where men has given up on us, they say there's a casting down. You say there's a lifting up. Oh, yes, the chief cornerstone that was rejected, the cornerstone that was rejected has become the chief cornerstone. They looked and said, nothing good can come out of Nazareth. Can anything good come out of Nazareth? The hung of Jesus on the cross, oh, yes, snaring, making fun of him. If only they knew the third day was going to rise again. They've looked down on us. They've thought of it. Nothing good can come out of this one. But you showed up mighty. You showed up big on our behalf. Yes, Lord, everything we need, you're bringing it to alignment. It is aligning in our favor. It is coming together for our good. It is working in our favor. We thank you, mighty God, for your portion. Yes, Lord. You are a portion. You are a provider. There's nothing we have need of that you have not already supplied for us. We thank you, Father. We begin to receive it, Lord. We thank you, Lord. You have promised us houses that we did not build, you will give unto us, filled with goodly things. We believe, we receive. We thank it in the name of Jesus. Wells we did not dig. Vineyards we did not plant. Is nothing to you. Absolutely nothing to you. For the earth is the Lord's and the fullness thereof. There's nothing impossible with you. Nothing impossible with you. Yes, Lord. Oh yes, we break through every form of limitation in the name of Jesus. Father, Lord, it's nothing for you. Father, Lord, you sent, oh yes, you sought after David. You sought David out. Father, you seek us out. You will single us out in the name of Jesus. You will choose us. Yes, Lord, you will choose us. You will single us out in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, you turn your face upon us. Cause your face to shine upon us in the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen. We're going to pray a prayer of acceleration. God is the God that speeds things up. You know, during the week, I saw this article, and the headline just caught my attention. It says, Florida woman gives birth to twins in a year, two sets of twins in a year. Because I went to it, and I was like, two sets of twins. And it's the truth. This lady, she's young. I don't know, maybe she's in her 30s from how she looks. But she gave birth to a set of twins, boys, March 2019. And she gave birth to the second set, December 2019. I don't know how. But what came to my mind is not as much as the baby. It's like, this is divine acceleration. And she had a two-year-old baby girl before. And I'm like, what? In 3 years, she had five children. Ideally, the process would be, if she was going to have these children, it would normally take 10 to 11 years. The Lord is going to compress time for us in the name of Jesus. We're going to pray. The Lord will accelerate our progress in the name of Jesus. He will grant us supernatural speed. He will cause that impossible, because that situation is impossible. Doctors could not explain it. Somebody that just had twins, carrying twins again almost immediately. It was unexplainable, and she gave birth to them. Healthy babies. The Lord would accelerate our progress. He will grant us speed. In Nehemiah 6, we saw the story of Nehemiah. He was trying to build, Nehemiah 6:15. He was building the wall, and Sanballat and Tobiah and everybody came against it. But he said Nehemiah finished it in 52 days. Compressed time, less than when he was expected, even in the midst of contention, even in the midst of the enemy coming against him. The Lord sped it up. He finished it even before they expected. They said even when his enemies said, they could not believe it. They were afraid. They knew that this just could be God. So will it be. The Lord will confound those that have gathered against us. The Lord will confound those that looked down and thought it can never be so. The Lord himself will cause it to be a wonder even to us ourselves. It will be unexplainable in the name of Jesus. What the Lord has planned and purposed concerning us, no man will be able to explain. We will not even be able to explain it. We will look at it ourselves and say, how could this have come to pass? How could this happen? But only God. That would just be the only solution. Only God could have done this. Only God can do this. We're going to thank God, the God that speeds things up. It says with Elijah, when they said there was going to be no rain, and then it was going to rain, he said the hand of God came upon Elijah, strengthened him, and cast him to run far further than Ahab's chariot. Is only the hand of God. The hand of God will speak things up for us in the name of Jesus. The mighty outstretched arms of God will cast us to experience speed in unusual ways, not explainable. No man will be able to explain it. They will bypass the normal process. He will bypass the natural process. He will compress time for us. This year of possibilities. In the mighty name of Jesus. Yes, we know that the Lord will be saying 1,000 souls this year. The Lord can give us in the first quarter of the year. It's but nothing to God. It's but nothing. He says a little shall become 1,000. A small one, a strong nation. I, the Lord, will hasten it. The Lord himself will hasten all that he has purposed and planned for us. All he has spoken concerning us, he will hasten it. He will speed it up in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, no man will be able to explain it. Yes, we will see the campuses exploding. It can take us three levels of promotion within this year. What should have been, you go one level and wait another 2-3 years before you go to the next level. In 1 year, it can take us three levels higher. That is our God. The God of possibilities. 1,000 times more. Unexplainable. Impossible situations come impossible. Opening unto us doors that no man can open. No man can open but only the hand of God. Only the hand of God. It will cause the double gates to be opened unto us. The double gates, it says, your gates shall be opened continually, day and night, that the wealth of the Gentiles shall be brought to us day and night. You're sleeping, you're awake. Our gates are open. Our doors are open. Our bank account is open. Oh yes, the wealth will be transferred in the name of Jesus. The resources needed will be coming from far near. The people we need, they will be coming to look for us day and night, while we're busy minding our business, while we're busy serving the Lord and in church, the Lord is already minding our own business. In the name of Jesus, day and night, our gates shall be open continually. It shall be open continually. It shall be open continually. The double gates, they shall be open, never to be shut again. Oh yes, no more aborted dreams. No more aborted visions. No more one step ahead and 10 steps behind. Progressive growth. Accelerated progressive growth. From glory to glory. That is what his word says. We believe his word. Our path is shining brighter and brighter. It can only get better. It can only get better. We're not going backwards. We are going forward. That spirit of retrogression is destroyed. In the name of Jesus, by the power in the blood of Jesus, we break it to yoke off of your neck. In the name of Jesus. Oh yes, we're going forward. We're going higher. We're increasing. We're enlarging. We're expanding to the right and to the left. In the mighty name of Jesus. Oh yes, we cannot be stopped. We cannot be hindered. In the name of Jesus, we break every form of limitation. We stop it in the name of Jesus. We refuse to be limited in our thinking. We refuse to be limited in our growing forward. We refuse to be limited in our lifting. Oh yes, we pray over our children. Yes, Lord, accelerated progressive growth. Oh yes, continuous success in every area. In the mighty name of Jesus. The outstretched hand of God protecting us everywhere we go. The hand of God upon us, the hand of God shielding and protecting us, the hand of God leading us, guiding and directing us into a wealthy place. Oh yes, a place, a flourishing place, a place of fulfillment. Rest all around, rest all around, rest all around. This is a season we enter into full rest. Full rest is so David, you have fought the battle. Your son Solomon will enter into rest. We will enter into rest. Our children's children will enter into rest. They will not fight the battles we have fought. In the name of Jesus, for we take that victory in Jesus' name. We receive the victory in the name of Jesus. It is ours in the name of Jesus. No more battles. We enter into a season of all round rest in the name of Jesus. We step into this decade into rest. Doors that we did not knock on will begin to open unto us. All we have struggled for will begin to come at ease. He says, this blessing shall run after you and overtake you. In the name of Jesus, we enter into that season. The blessing running after us and overtaking us. In the name of Jesus, more than enough, overflowing. We enter into all that Amos 9:13 says. He says, before we're recovering from one blessing, another blessing is coming. Another blessing is coming. Our head will begin to swim because we just can't fathom or imagine it. Overflowing blessing. In the name of Jesus, overflowing blessing. A season of overflow. A season of more than enough. A flourishing season. A thriving season. In the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, Father, Lord, for accelerating all that concerns us. Thank you for accelerating all that concerns us. Thank you for by your hand you propel us forward. Hey, far above. It doesn't matter how those that have gone ahead of us. Oh yes, like Elijah went ahead of Ahab's chariot. So will you bring us and lift us forward. In the name of Jesus. We thank you for the stone that has been rejected, has become the chief cornerstone. We break the yoke of rejection. We receive rejection. Oh yes, that one that has been rejected now has become an eternal excellence. The joy of many generations. Hallelujah. Oh yes, put the vision before you. Like Habakkuk said, I will do cartwheels of joy. Begin to do cartwheels of joy in the spirit. Begin to do cartwheels of joy in the spirit. No, not only will the Lord bring it to pass, he will accelerate it. He will compress time in our favor. In the name of Jesus, he will compress time in our favor. In the name of Jesus, he will grant us supernatural speed in the mighty name of Jesus. No more struggling for us. The Lord said, I will listen it. I will do it. The hand of God, oh yes, bringing it to pass. Everything we need, bringing it into our lives, along our path, the right people. Oh yes, destiny helpers, men of influence, people that can help us. In the name of Jesus, destiny connectors, timely helpers, they will be there right on time. They will be there at the time that we need the help in the name of Jesus, and they have the resources to help us in the name of Jesus. People that will help push our vision, the Lord for your positioning them in our lives. They stand by us like Ruth stood with Naomi. Even when she had nothing to gain, seemingly, she stood by Naomi and she was rewarded. Naomi was rewarded. Their joy was full. The Lord gave them a new beginning and he changed the path and the course of their lives forever. They became connected to our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The Lord will bring people that will stand with us even at that time. In the name of Jesus, they will stand. They will not be moved. They will not leave. In the name of Jesus, the Lord will bring people with the right resources, people that can connect us, people that just need to say a word. That's all they need to say, and we are positioned where we should be positioned. That which we need suddenly is provided for us. In the name of Jesus, it will cause men to stand before kings in our favor. Oh yes, Gehazi was with a king. Even at the time the Shunammite woman came in, after she had left and been in famine for 7 years, just at the time he was talking to the king, she walked in. At the right time we will walk in, and everything that was us was restored back unto her. Even like we learned, oh yes, that which you didn't labor for. People worked for 7 years tilling our farm, and everything was paid to her. Our farm was given to her. Our house was given to her. We will experience unusual restoration. Men will work for us in the name of Jesus. We will take all that is ours in the name of Jesus. Timely, timely, timely plan. He said, says the footsteps of the righteous are ordered of him. We will be at the right place at the right time. We pray over our children. We will be at the right place at the right time. In the mighty name of Jesus, we thank you, Father. We begin to cover our blessings in the blood of Jesus. We begin to cover this vision in the blood of Jesus. Oh, yes, we begin to cover the dreams. Oh, yes, we begin to seal it in your blood. Oh, yes, the enemy will not exact upon it. There will be no delay. There will be no distraction. In the name of Jesus, there will be no disruption. In the mighty name of Jesus, let's begin to plead the blood of Jesus over our children concerning their destiny. Let's just speak in the spirit. Oh, yes, over them in this season. Oh, yes, we plead the blood of Jesus over them, over their destiny. It will not be delayed. It will not be distracted. They will not be distracted. It will not be disrupted. They will fulfill destiny at the right time, at the right time, at the right time. The Lord will compress time in their favor. In the mighty name of Jesus, wherever they may be, they will not lack help. Oh, yes, timely helpers positioned in their lives. Men like angels, wherever they are, helping them, guiding them, directing them. We declare and decree our children are taught of the Lord. Great is their peace. They are far from oppression. In this land, they are established in righteousness. They will make the right choices. In the mighty name of Jesus, they will stand boldly for Jesus, proudly for Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we seal them in the blood of Jesus. We seal their minds in the blood of Jesus. We seal their going, their coming in the blood of Jesus. Oh, yes, we begin to speak godly relationships, mentors. Oh, yes, we begin to surround them with it. In the name of Jesus, wherever they may be, the right people, oh yes, positioned rightly in their lives, in their path, in the name of Jesus. There will not be a statistics in this land. We refuse it. We reject it in the name of Jesus. We disallow it in the name of Jesus. We have less than a minute. Just thank God for what he has done for you. Thank God, because we know when we pray, says we should believe we have answers to our prayers. We know the Lord has heard us. We know he has answered us. We know he has shifted things supernaturally, miraculously in our favor. Oh, yes, we'll experience suddenly, unexplainable suddenly. In the name of Jesus, all things working together for our good. All things aligning in our favor. All things falling in place for us. In the mighty name of Jesus, unexplainable, miraculously, supernaturally, in the mighty name of Jesus, it will be obvious that the hand of God, only God can do this. Only God could have brought this to pass. Father, we give you all the glory. We bless and we worship you. We exalt your holy name. We lift your name on high. We are grateful for this time in your presence. We are grateful for your presence that's tabernacled with us this evening. We thank you because we know you have heard and you have answered us. And we give glory to your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Amen, amen, amen. God bless you all. Tomorrow morning we'll meet on the bridge and in our various campuses in the evening. Have a blessed evening and rejoice. Cartwheels of joy. Amen. Hallelujah.